Hi children, in this video I am going to discuss with you 7th class mathematics, the two very special concept, commutative property. Under addition, subtraction, multiplication and also division. So firstly, under addition, in commutative property, if a plus b is equal to b plus a, then commutative property will satisfies. In subtraction, if a minus b is equal to b minus a, commutative property will satisfies. Under multiplication, if a into b is equal to b into a, commutative property will satisfies. Under division, if a divided by b is equal to b divided by a, commutative property will satisfies. So firstly, I am going to verify commutative property under addition. So first you take two integers. 2 is one integer, 3 is an integer, 2 plus 3. 2 plus 3 is equal to, how to write in all hs? 3 plus 2, 3 plus 2. 2 plus 3 equal to 5, 3 plus 2 also equal to 5. Means commutative property satisfied. Commutative property satisfied under addition. So commutative property satisfied under addition because a plus b value is equal to b plus a. So commutative property satisfied. Next I am going to check commutative property under subtraction. A minus b, same numbers. I am going to take 2 minus 3 equal to 3 minus 2. 2 minus 3 value is equal to minus 1 and 3 minus 2 value equal to plus 1. Minus 1 plus 1, they are not equal. So commutative property under subtraction is not satisfied. It is not satisfied. Commutative property not satisfied under subtraction. Yeah. Next, commutative property under multiplication. Take these two numbers. 2 into 3 equal to 3 into 2. 2 threes are 6. 3 twos are also 6. Yes, commutative property satisfied under multiplication. It is satisfied under multiplication. Next, commutative property under division. 2 divided by 3. 2 divided by 3 equal to 3 divided by 2. 2 divided by 3 means like this. That is 3 divided by 2 means 3 divided by 2 means like this. 3 zeros 0, 2 will get. Keep your point here, 3 6 are 18. So this division is going on forever. 2 1s are 2, 1. And keep your point, 2 5s are 10, 0. So here in division we are getting decimal numbers, children. 0.6 bar and 1 is, 1 more is 1.5. So they are not equal. So that commutative property under division is not satisfied. Commutative property under division not satisfied. Because it is getting decimal numbers. When we doing division in LHS and RHS, they are getting decimal numbers. If they are decimal numbers, they are not integers actually. Integers. They are not integers actually. So that under division commutative property is not satisfied. So totally what we say, that means commutative property under addition and multiplication satisfied. Under subtraction, under division, it is not satisfied. So that this is the concept of commutative property on integers. So now I am going to give some problems over to you. Is commutative property satisfies or not, you check and you verify by doing some problems solvently. So first one, under addition. First problem, 2 plus 3 equal to 3 plus 2. Second problem, 3 plus 7 equal to 7 plus 3. Third problem, 5 plus 8 equal to 8 plus 5. These are the homework to you. Come on, verify these problems. Next, under multiplication. Commutative property under multiplication. First one, 2 into 3 equal to 3 into 2. Second one, 3 into 7 equal to 7 into 3. Fourth one, 5 into 8 equal to 8 into 5. Commutative property under multiplication. Come on, you verify. Are they satisfies or not? If they satisfies, below each and every problem you write, it is satisfied. Commutative property satisfied under addition, under multiplication. And also you verify some more problems. Commutative property under subtraction. Commutative property under subtraction. Under subtraction, is it satisfying or not? 3 minus 5 equal to 5 minus 3. First one, second one, 7 minus 8 is equal to 8 minus 7. Third one, minus 3 minus 8 is equal to 8 minus 3. Satisfies or not? Now, commutative property under division. Satisfies or not? Come on, you verify. First problem, 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2 divided by 4. Second one is 9 divided by 3 is equal to 3 divided by 9. Third problem, 10 divided by 2 is equal to 2 divided by 10. Come on, you verify commutative property under subtraction and division also. So we already know that it is not satisfies under division and under subtraction. It is satisfies under addition and multiplication. So children,